What we're going to look at in this video is the DAX SUM function and the DAX SUMX function. Now, both of these functions work in Power Pivot and they also work in Power BI. As usual, we're going to look at this example using Power Pivot because when you use Power Pivot, it's much easier to see the end result of your calculation or your measure than when you're using Power BI. So what we have is we have a sales table and we've got the date, invoice number, customer ID, product ID, we have quantity and we have sales. We also have a products table and it contains a products ID, a category, a name, a color, a supplier ID, a cost price and also a sales price. Now what we want to do is we want to be able to calculate the total of the sales or the sum of the sales. And we're going to look at this in a number of different ways. First, we're going to look at the normal sum function. Then we're going to look at the SUMX. We're going to talk about the differences between the two of them and when you should use each one of them. So before we start, if this DAX series is something that you are interested in, if you'd like to learn more, if you're finding this video useful, please do comment in the comments below. And don't forget to give this video the thumbs up and share it with your colleagues and friends. So the first thing that we notice is that we already have a sales figure in our table of data that we've loaded into Power Pivot. Now, don't forget, this is the same as if you were using Power BI. And if we wanted to get the total of all of these sales, we could add in a measure. Now, in Excel 2013 in Power Pivot, the measures can be done in this calculation part of the screen. You can show and you can hide the calculation area using this calculation area toolbox. So let's go ahead and calculate our sales. So selecting the cell down here in our calculation field, if we put in equal sum, and we'll see here in our formula bar, we can select sum, like with Excel. Now what it's looking for is a column name. So if you start with the table name, and we know our table name is sales, and we can see the T in there to see that it's sales, but we want to take our sales column in our sales table. And then we can hit enter. Now what we'll do is we'll just make this a little bit bigger so we can actually see the value that's come in into our calculated field or into our measure. Now we can rename this total sales. So what we've done there is we have taken a column that is already in the table and we've just summed this column. But what if we didn't have the sales value in this table here? What if we only had the quantity and we wanted to get the total sales? Well, what we do have in our products table is we have a sales price in our products table. So because these are joined together by relationship, we can multiply in our sales table our quantity multiplied by our sales price to give us our actual sales value. Now what we're going to do is that will give us our sales value for each particular row. We will then need to sum this to get the total sales. So let's have a look at adding this into a calculated column rather than into a measure. To do this, we need to use the related function. So let's quickly have a look at this. What we want to do is we want to start with equals and we're in the column. So we're going to take our quantity and we're going to multiply our quantity. And what are we going to multiply it by? Well, we need to look at the related function. And we're going to our related table of products. And in our products, we are going to get our sales price. So basically what this formula says is take the quantity and then go over to the table products, find the related sales price for this particular product and then multiply it by the quantity and we can hit enter. And what this will now do is this will now actually calculate the sales for us. And I'm going to right click and I'm going to rename this column and I'm going to call this calculated sales because we already have in a column that has sales. So that is our calculated sales. Now, if we wanted to get our total sales, we would say equals to sum, and we would go to our sales table and we would take our calculated sales, and we would be able to then get the total value for our sales if we actually didn't have sales in this table. So that's how we would reach into another table. We would carry out a calculation and then we would get our total sales. But this way is quite long. And what we will find is it's also very resource intensive if you are using Power Pivot, because each one of these calculations is actually stored in the model because it is a calculated column and it's not a measure. Whereas this is a measure and this is a measure, so they're only calculated when they're actually needed. But this particular column here is calculated by way of a calculated column. So what DAX does is it goes to the first row, and in the first row it goes to the quantity, it hops over to the products table, it looks for the sales price of the products table and multiplies it. It then goes down to the next row and does the exact same thing for the next row. So this is at row level, and this is an important concept of DAX to actually understand as you progress through your DAX studies and get more involved in DAX. What we're going to look at now is another solution for this calculated sales. So let's assume we didn't have, again, we didn't have this sales column in our table of data, and we didn't want to have a new calculated column. All we wanted to do is actually have a measure. Well, what we can do now is we can use the SUMX function. And what the SUMX function will do is the SUMX function will allow you to sum things across different tables. Let me show you what I mean. What we'll do is we'll calculate a new measure down here. And our new measure is going to be SUMX. And SUMX says it returns the sum of an expression evaluated for each row in a table. So it's a table function, and the first thing it's looking for is the table. So what table is it that this calculation is going to take place in? Well, the table is going to be our sales table. Now it's saying, okay, well, what expression do you want to sum in the sales table? Well, basically your expression is your formula. So our formula is going to be our quantity. So we're going to take the sales table and we're going to take quantity. And as before, we're going to multiply this by the related function. And we're going to go to our products table. And in our products table, we are going to go to our sales price and we're going to close the bracket. Now, what is this formula saying? Well, the formula is saying, go to the sales table, get the sales quantity, multiply the sales quantity by the related product price. So it'll go one by one, row by row, down through the sales table, taking the sales quantity, multiplying it by the related price in the products table. And then when it's done all that, what it's then going to do is it's going to go to this outer formula, SUMX, and it's going to sum all of these together. Now I just need to close the second bracket because I only had the first bracket closed. I need to close the bracket on the SUMX formula. We can also change the name of our calculated field, which is also a measure, and we can change the name of this to total sales SUMX. Just because we already have total sales in, and we have sales and we have calculated sales in. And we can see now that our total sales produced in this manner using the SUMX function gives us the same result as the SUM function that we used by just adding up the sales column, and also then by using the relate function to look up the sales price and multiply it by the quantity. I'm doing that as a calculated column and then creating a measure to total this calculated column. So SUMX in effect means that you don't really need to have loaded sales or to have loaded sales into your model in the first place, and you don't need to always create calculated columns. This measure that we have now created, it can be sliced and it can be diced. You see, the SUMX function, it's an iterator, and this is a term that you will become more familiar with. And what that means is that it defines the row context for the DAX formula. So that means it tells DAX on which rows that the calculation should be carried out. And when you add this to a visualization or to a pivot table, and then you add filters on it, the row context has already been defined by using this SUMX function. So the row context and the filter context are things to take into consideration when you're creating DAX measures. So that's the SUM function and the SUMX function.
Hi, my name is Paula and thanks for watching. Here at the Excel Club, I offer online Excel and Power BI courses for all levels. We have free courses to get you started and premium courses on more advanced and specialised Excel and Power BI training. You can access these courses on the website and from our apps, and there's links below the video, so please do explore them. We also offer custom Power BI and Excel solutions. So if you want to create custom financial models or a Power BI dashboard, then I can help you. You can find contact details also on the website. If you haven't already, I hope that you'll take the time now to give this video the thumbs up, like and subscribe. Don't be shy. Feel free to comment below and say hi. See you next time. Bye now.